Thank you very much, Laurie Anderson, and I'm very pleased because we've got Sinead O'Connor with us, ladies and gentlemen. Sinead O'Connor. Again, I'm very pleased that you're on the show, I have to ask you, what the first thing, sort of music that you listened to that got you interested in music was when you were a child in Ireland?
The very first thing I remember being influenced by was Bob Dylan's album Slow Train Coming, and particularly the song called Gotta Serve Somebody. That was the first thing that made me really want to be a singer. Yeah.
Now, on your new record, Fire on Babylon, it owes quite a lot to a reggae. There's like quite a strong reggae influence. What attracts you to reggae? Are you a reggae fan?
Yeah, very much so. Bob Marley obviously would be a big influence of mine. Particularly, I like the Rasta element. I like the way they've observed for years before we ever did that the Catholic Church have basically been duping people for years and have misrepresented God quite severely, actually. And I like the way, basically, the courage that the Rastas have had for years before even the Irish got to it in identifying the Catholic Church as being basically against God.
Now, we asked you to select some video. Mm-hmm. What is the piece that you've selected for us?
I selected Crazy Bald Heads. I like it because I hear a lot in Rastafarianism which reminds me of Ireland, and I hear a lot of Irishness in it. The experience of the Irish people has been very similar, obviously, to the experience of the African people. What I like about the song is that Bob Marley identifies correctly that the way in which the church gained control over all sorts of races of people was by taking over the educational systems of the countries into which they went. So that's basically what I like about the song, and how he has the courage to come out and say, here comes the con man coming with his con plan. So that's why I like it. So I'll shut up now.
Let's have a look at it. That's what I say. So, ladies and gentlemen, your selection of Bob Marley. There he is. Look.
Here comes the con man. Coming with us, come plan. We won't take no bribe. We've got to stay alive. We're gonna chase those crazy.
You've done a lot of duets with people.
Yes.
And you've done a duet with, and you were on the David Letterman show the other evening, duetting with Van Morrison, with the Chieftains behind you, and you seemed to be sort of howling with laughter. Tell me about what was going on there.
He was, or I was?
Well, both of you were.
I was laughing at him. I couldn't believe how funny he was. Because also, it's quite weird, because you meet somebody like Van Morrison, the thing that keeps going through your mind is, my God, this man is really ordinary. You know what I mean? Like, I was expecting him to be really unusual or something, but he wasn't, so... So kind of laughing at that, but he's just this ordinary guy, and he was kind of pissed. And he was flirting with me, sort of, as well, which I couldn't believe. I found that hard to believe if Van Morrison's face was right in my face, like, you know. And I was supposed to not kiss him or something.
Well, not on screen, surely. Yeah, I'd have kissed him. No, I wouldn't.
Well, I would have, except his girlfriend was there. So.
Thank you very much for coming on. And we'll look forward to two numbers from you in a moment. So, ladies and gentlemen, Sinead O'Connor. Thank you very much indeed, Sinead O'Connor. We'll be hearing more of her later. It's not. This is my grief
Car, beautiful music.